guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm sure you already noticed I'm outside today. I didn't feel like recording inside a closed environment anymore, so I thought I was going to come out, stroll, walk a bit, and see like if my mood would be suitable for a video. Yeah, so disclaimer, okay, you need to wear your mask if you're going outside. It's just because I'm still on my school campus. I haven't left my school campus, so we're not allowed to go out, and those who come in here are checked. So that's why I don't wear my mask for the video, because of course you wouldn't see me. So anyways, so that brings me to my topic of today. I wanted to talk about something that has been on the internet for a while, I think about 2 weeks or so. It's this I'll call it the war of accents. Okay, so it happens that some people were backlashing a certain Nigerian YouTuber for his accent, and I just wanted to comment on that because this is somebody who was raised in Nigeria. Remember that however you speak is always influenced by your environment, okay? However you speak is influenced by your environment. So if you grew up in a particular place, you'd speak a particular way. But that does not mean you wouldn't be understood if you speak English. I don't know why people always feel a need or this pressure, or they just have this satisfaction when you speak the way they want you to speak. And it's just a pity that this English language we speak right now was brought from somewhere, so you can never really speak it like the people who own the language. You'd speak it in your own way, you add your own varieties to it, there'll be terms you pronounce differently, which is very okay. Sometime ago somebody told me, Daruska, even if you were kind of rapping in your video, you still laugh the same way. I'm like, first of all, okay, let me tell you guys something. I'm sorry about the noise. In China, there's building everywhere all the time, so you have to get used to the sound. Okay, so let me tell you guys something here. I majored in English language. My bachelor's degree is in English language. So already, because of that, I may pronounce different words differently from some people because I learned it, but that's not how originally I would pronounce it if I had to just pick it up from my environment. And I also had an interest, like a particular interest in English and articulating words the way they're supposed to be articulated, you see. But it's not rapping. I can't come on here and fake an American accent. I've never been to the US before. Okay, someone who's grown up like 15 or 16 or 17 or 20 years in Cameroon, or 18, and goes to the US for 2 years and after a while comes up with this American accent, it can never be the same with an American. Don't get it twisted, okay? Don't get it twisted. It can never ever be the same. There's always going to be a characteristic in your language that's going to depict where you're from, which is not a bad thing, mind you, it's not a bad thing. So when I saw people bashing that guy because he speaks the way he's supposed to speak because of his nationality, the same Nigerians, I hear all kinds of, there are so many varieties of pronunciation in Nigeria, you cannot even single out one particular thing and say, oh, this is Nigerian's accent. No, because people in the north will speak differently from people in the south. It's the same thing in Cameroon. Even though we're from the northwest region or the southwest region, we all speak English, but it's not going to be the same. The way Kom people speak it is different from the way Bansa people speak it, and all those kind of things. There's always just, and that trace in your language is simply your identity. That's your identity you're carrying with you, and you don't even know. Like, I can't come on here and be fake or try to claim like, oh, you just want to be da 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 da. We, all of us can do that. You pick up a few sentences in movies and come and deceive people with it. No, but the information you listen to, the things you watch, the place you grew up in, all of that, it influences your English. So if you say something in a particular way because, oh, for example, you watch hip-hop, loving hip-hop, and you love the way they speak, and unconsciously you start saying some things in a particular way, it's because you watch Love and Hip Hop too much. So it's going to be incorporated in your language. It's not a bad thing. Just own it, own your language, own your accent. There's no shame in there. I can't even be deceived by that thing. Like, we catch you. Like, even when we're in China, if you know China, they don't even speak English. Just because if you don't make a conscious effort to improve your English, within a year your English is going to be whack. So on a daily basis, I make sure, like, I do a conscious effort to keep my English, like, at a particular rate. If not, you wouldn't notice it. It's very unconscious. Your English is going to die. So we'll gather as international students, and the moment you open your mouth, I know, oh, you're from Kenya, I know, oh, you're from South Africa, and he's going to be, oh, no, I'm from the US, did you grow up in New York, da, 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 da. You don't even need to do that. I'll catch you. You cannot even sustain a 30-minute conversation without me knowing and spotting where you're from. So all these people who go abroad 1 year, 6 months, their accents have somersaulted and they've changed, don't believe all that shit. It's a lie. It's a big lie. Even if you live in the UK, unless you really make a conscious effort, like your friends are only maybe from Wessex, because even people in Wessex don't speak the same as people in, I don't really know, like, there's so many different accents in the UK. Even though they own that language, they speak it differently. Then what makes you think you come on here and speak English like mother, until you'll be bashing your own people? Nigerians bashing a Nigerian for speaking like a Nigerian.
I grew up in Lagos, Nigeria, which is where I have lived all my life, but I always wondered what it would be like to live in Johannesburg, South Africa. Getting a great apartment in Lagos is expensive, especially if you are getting it on the island, which is an affluent area of Lagos, Nigeria. Today we are going to be comparing what 1,000.
Truth be told, guys, I don't see anything wrong with this video. His videography is awesome and his English is clear and understandable. You guys should give him a break already and just grow up. Like, that doesn't even make sense to me, and I just feel like, but anyway, that was just what I wanted to say. So it's just to wake you up a little, just to wake you up a little. Like, all those things don't make sense, truly. So don't even worry about it. Anyways, guys, my birthday is next week and I'm so excited. Like, this is my birth month. I'm a Taurus baby, and yeah, so you guys should wait for what I'm keeping for you next week. Bye, and so I'll see you in my next one. Like, I needed this lockdown to actually push me to think out of the box and to give you content back to back. Pew pew pew.
Hold up, wait a minute, it's a 22, pew pew pew, pew pew pew, hold up, wait a minute, it's a 22, pew pew pew, pew pew pew.